I think many of us are wondering, heads spinning, about how to hold the recent events in D.C., along with a discussion from Sri Atmananda. We are doing the World Peace Meditation daily, working on our obstacles and structures, aiming to meet the tide of the gunas, studying the Gita, preparing to be useful. Is there more in the way of becoming a universal channel, or more general comments which may help me, us, today?
Well, for you, John, it's not to take responsibility for the suffering of others. It's to back away and know that there are forces at work which you can't control or make a difference in, except for having a certain willingness to be present with the costs and the qualities of human suffering that is occurring. That's empathetic quality of yourself that expands to other people, but also to this current situation. So it's a sign that you are an ideal person and that you have a kind of a moral sense of your role in the world, and all these are wonderful human qualities. But to do something, well, part of what you're really doing is learning to handle the part of your childhood, the part of you that gets overtaken by events you can't control. Again, it's the bits and pieces of ourself that doesn't have the sufficient boundaries to know what you can change and what you can't. And that vulnerability leaves you in this uncertain place. So that's actually what to attend to. The thing in your body that's going on when these thoughts and ideas, as you look at the world situation. For me, the world situation is evidence of transformation. I think that what happened July 6th is an epiphany moment, and that it is evidence.
January 6th.
Yeah. That it is the break of the pattern of darkness. So for me, it was like wonderful. And it's always a shitstorm when things wake up. And we're now in the repercussions, but I got to tell you, the corrective action is already in place. So hell, this is like a tremendously important time for humanity that we're going through. So it's in that sense, you can hold it from that vantage point and therefore have at least a different story that where you're not overtaken by dread or worry or anxiety or grief. Yeah, I mean, that's gonna feel better. And when you're in that place, you are a more effective person. And when you can include that, then when Polly shows up or when your kid calls or, you get another notice from the medical board, you're there in equanimity and say, oh, shit's happening, here I am again. It is therefore, that's really how you can make the difference. Be with yourself, be in truth. All right.